Howdy, it's Bergs, and this is the Zoom A3, a very high-quality preamp, effects device, and modeler specifically aimed at the acoustic guitar. It's quite involved, but once you get to know it, it is quite simple to use, and I have to say that I've been using it for about the last 5 or 6 months on the road, and it has not let me down, and I would find it extremely difficult to travel without it now because it sounds so good and offers so much. Let's have a look at it from the top down. You can actually choose between 16 different body types up here to suit your guitar. Now, I'm playing a Martin OM28E, and so I've chosen the orchestra type here, which is actually modelled after an OM28. Next of all, you've got a 3-band EQ, so if you choose to, you can add or subtract a little bit of bass, middle or treble. I've got them sitting at fairly flat positions for the purposes of this demonstration. On the left, over here, you've got a balance control, which will let you balance between the dry signal of the guitar and the wet signal. Over here, we've got a microphone input control. You can actually plug your guitar directly into the side of the A3 unit, or you can plug a microphone in as well, and you can actually shift the mic's position in between any of the three effect positions. That's a little more than I'm going to demonstrate here, but it offers a lot of versatility. You've got the pickup overall master control, so you don't clip your guitar, and at the moment it's reading green, which is exactly where I want it, but I can lower or raise that as need be, and an overall master output here. These little controls, menu and types, all have different functions depending on what state the unit is actually in. On the left here, we've got the feedback foot switch. And the feedback foot switch is a search and destroy device. It, once pressed, will listen for anything that's feeding back through your monitoring system. So it has found 83 hertz. Now, I can actually make that shallower, the notch filter, or deeper. And it will let me also find two other frequencies if they're giving me trouble. And if I keep pressing it, there's the second frequency, third frequency. If I press it again, it clears it. This is the master foot switch. It will take you into tuner mode, and it will also turn on and off specific effects depending on which mode we have the A3 in. So for the tuner, for example, all I've got to do is hold it and press it again. You can save up to 20 different effect settings. Now, I've got 4 in here at the moment. As you can see, I've called it Comp Cabin, which is a compressor and a reverb. And I've got a chorus room, and I've got a tremolo, lush. I've named all these myself. And the fourth one is just a bypass straight through the A3. So that means that I can just flick through those 4. You can give each of the presets a letter. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, so on and so forth, and as many letters as there are will determine how many presets you can cycle through. That's also very handy. You've got 40 different effect types, more than I can possibly show you here. On the right-hand side of the A3 is the pickup input, and you can choose between piezo, flat, or magnetic type pickups with a little slider switch there. On the rear, we've got the mic input, the on and off control, a ground switch, and on the left, we've got unbalanced left and right outputs if you want to run it in stereo, and also a USB connection there so you can update the firmware if need be. Let's go back to basics now. At the moment, I've got the balance on dry, so the guitar just sounds like this straight to the desk. Now, of course, I can use this balance control to bring in the wet signal. But as you can see, my preset number 4 is bypassed, which means I have no effects. If I wanted to go to my reverb and compressor, my chorus room, my lush tremolo, and bypass again. Now, let's say we wanted to turn bypass actually into something a bit more usable than just a dry thing. So I go exit, and I go exit, and I go exit. 3 effect positions we have, 1, 2, and 3. Effect 1 is always one of the different types of modeling guitars, and you can turn it on and off like this. So I've got a D28, I've got a D18. There we go, an OM28, which is exactly what I'm playing. So this is completely wet signal at the moment. The modeled version, let's have a listen to the dry version. Wow, it's not exact, but it's pretty damn close. So if I wanted to add a little bit of, say, 0021, I can blend that in here with the balance control. So all of the OM28, all of the 0021, or I can switch it off, or any other number of guitars, let's say a J45 Gibson. Get the idea? Now if I hit this little effect button here, I can go to my second position, which at the moment is through, but I can choose between one of about 40 different types of effects. So let's just go for something like the exciter. And I use the page buttons to get into the exciter, and you can see I've got bass, treble and level. If I want some more bass, I just turn it up. Same with the treble. I'll just leave them both fairly low. We'll leave the exciter on, and I think we'll make effect number 3 a phaser, of course. Now that's a bit too deep for me, so I'm going to drop it back to a 4-stage phaser. Nice. Now if I wanted to, I can go to my memory and I can hit enter, and I can actually store it into that bypass position. But I'm not going to do that because I quite like the bypass position. Last but not least is the boost foot switch over here, which is also very handy because every now and again you want to raise yourself above the din of whoever you're playing with all due respect. And so you would be able to do this. Again, you can get inside to the menu and you can adjust that boost position. And that, my friends, is a very quick look at the Zoom A3, which offers a whole lot. I have been touring with it for, as I said, for about 5 or 6 months, and it's been just fantastic. It's super quiet, has the tuner, has the anti-feedback, has a heap of different effects, and I love it. See you soon.